Good morning, everyone. If you have been following along, you know that I'm really committed to sharing tools with you to help you stay calm and centered and grounded so that you can keep going with your days and going with your business, even if everything feels like there's a lot of upheaval right now. I'm really excited to bring Rachel Stokes to you. Rachel is not only an energy worker, she's also an eating disorder recovery coach. So she's a life coach, man. She's like out there helping people keep their minds managed. And so she's here today to teach us a tool. And I'm actually going to have Rachel tell you everything about it. I know this tool, but I don't use it enough. And so I think that if we all use it a little bit more, we could get the racing thoughts that stay in our head to calm down. And I'm going to turn this over to Rachel, and she's going to teach you how to do this. So thanks for being here today, Rachel.
Well, thank you so much for having me. I'm really grateful to be here, and especially with what's going on today. So we have a loss of community. We're all quarantined. I know my little town, Galveston, is on lockdown. You can get out to, you know, go to the grocery store, that kind of thing. But we're not doing our daily routines. We're not seeing people, seeing clients over the phone, but I do a lot of group activities where we join together. And so my clients are missing that. My community's missing that. And I'm sure everybody else out there is missing that also. So this meditation is perfect for this time, because what we're going to do is we're going to cultivate that love and kindness feeling. And so right now we may not be feeling it ourselves because we're distanced. And a lot of times with the clients that I work with, the eating disorder recovery clients, they're feeling distant too. And they're feeling, they have a lot of shame and a lot of guilt. And some of my life coaching clients do too, but it's hard for them to cultivate that loving feeling for themselves and then also to bring it out to other people. So at this.
Can I ask you a question about that?
Yes, please do.
If you are feeling distanced and connection is important in your recovery or your healing, whatever it is you're recovering mm-hmm. and healing from, this distancing might send you back into some behaviors that are harmful. Yes.
Yes, it sure will.
Okay, so that's why this meditation that you're going to teach us is helpful, to give ourselves that connection.
To give ourselves that connection. And then also we're sending it out for other people to connect.
Okay.
So what's cool about it is you can heal from trauma. You can heal from past trauma, from trauma that's happening now, from stressful situations, anxiety, and also it's bringing the community together, sharing in love and kindness. That's what META stands for, love and kindness. And so what researchers have found, that if you practice this, you know, every day for 30 days, that you'll see a change. And that's what I see in my clients. So the very first thing that we focus on is self. And it's a lot of times it's hard for someone who's in recovery or even just in a stressful situation or low self-esteem to turn to that self-love because they don't really have it. So when you start off at day one and you're focusing on self, and then you're also focusing on the other people, and we'll go through that in a minute, by the time you get to day 30, you've seen such a big change. It's not as hard to bring up those loving kindness feelings toward yourself anymore because you've practiced this practice. And so we go through and we start off with self, and then we move to somebody that we respect, like a role model, a teacher, a pastor, a spiritual leader, somebody that we really, really look up to for inspiration and we feel that they're wise. And then we move to someone that we love deeply. And this can be a family member. It can be a best friend. It can even be a pet, because we all know how important pets are to us. And I know I love my pets just like their family members. After that, we move to a neutral person. And this is somebody that you can meet, you know, the cashier at the grocery store, somebody you pass on your daily walk and you just say, you know, hi to, somebody that you really don't have a connection to, but we still need to send them love and kindness. After that, we move to a more difficult person. It's somebody that we may hold hostility to, that it may even be somebody that we love, but they push our buttons and or we're totally disagreeing with them. And there's just that kind of anger, hostility towards them. And so a lot of times it's hard to send love and kindness to these people. So again, after the 30 days, if you do the 30 days challenge, you see how that changes. Because we all know anger cannot live where love lives. So we need to push out that anger and send the love and kindness. And then the last one, we're going to send it out to the world, to everybody, every living thing. So we're not just sending it out to people. We're sending it out to the plants because we know how important the plants are. We're sending it out to the pets, the animals, the animals that actually that we get our protein from. We want to send love and kindness out to every living being here on our planet. And in the end, we bring that all back to us so that we experience the love coming back that we're sending out to others.
So over the course of 30 days, you get better at this, and this makes more sense as you go through it. And even mm-hmm. though it can be hard, especially as you get toward day maybe 20 and you have to then bring in the person that you have to think about while you're meditating who drives you bonkers, you just get better and better at it.
You get better at it. Now, each time you're going to meditate on all of those people. So you're from the very get-go.
You're going to do
all six. And
are you going to take us through that today?
We're going to go through that. And there's, excellent. We'll go through the whole process. And it doesn't have to take a long time. Like we can do the whole meditation today, but in a busy world, if you want to wake up and you just want to quickly go through the meditation, you can actually just go through the steps. You just send it out once, twice, you know, three times. You go all the way to the sixth time and you release it. So you can make it as long as you want or as short as you like. So if y'all are ready, I can't hear you. Did you say something?
Oh, I just said, let's go. I'm excited. Oh,
okay, so this is great. One thing I do like to do before we do the meditation, and I do this with my clients, is I want us to open up our hearts and I want us to physically feel what that feels like. So a lot of times if I'm in a group, I'll have them stand, but we're sitting, so that's fine. And what you're going to do is you're going to take your hands. I'm going to kind of get up a little bit so you can see me. And you're going to pull and your shoulder blades are going to touch in the back. And do you feel that opening? And then I want you to press out. And that's the release. So you're going to pull in and open up. And then press out to give.
My God, that feels so good just to do it.
So we're going to pull in and open up. And we're actually pulling our heart open. And then we're releasing that love into the world. And the reason why we do this, because you can create that physical feeling. Did you feel it when you pulled open your heart? So you're creating a physical feeling. So when you're doing the meditation, you can actually do this movement if you like. You can have your hands on your lap. There's no wrong way, but you have felt that movement. So you can think about that movement in your mind. You can feel it in your chest as you're opening up to give. So again, you're going to get in a comfortable position, and I like to have my feet grounded on the floor, and a lot of times I do it barefoot so I can wiggle my toes into the earth. Of course, I have wood floors right now, but you're going to get comfortable. You can sit with your back straight, your bottom planted firmly on your chair, and really feel that connection between your sit bones and where you're sitting. And then place your arms however you like. I normally do an active meditation where I'm taking in and out the energy. Again, you can have your hands just up. A lot of people like to put one hand on the heart and one hand on the belly. There's no wrong way to do this. So you're just going to get comfortable. And I like to close my eyes. We're going to start with our breath. So we're going to breathe in a deep breath. Breathe it deep and release. And you can breathe in through your nose. And release. And with each release, I want you to start feeling a little bit more calm and a little bit more relaxed. So breathe in. And release. You start to feel your shoulders soften and droop. Your neck isn't as stiff. You're going to fall into your natural breathing rhythm. I want you to feel that you're in a safe place. With each breath, I want you to imagine a loving energy flowing through your body. You can feel this energy swirl around your head, going down into your neck and shoulders, into your chest. This loving energy going through your arms and out your fingers. You can feel it going into your abdomen and stomach. This loving energy around your pelvic area and down into your thighs. You're feeling very relaxed and open. Swirls around your knees and down into your calves, your ankles, your feet, and out your toes. You're feeling very grounded. You're feeling settled. And you're feeling open. At this time, I would like for you to think back to a time when you felt loved, when you felt pure love coming into your heart. It could have been from a parent or a grandparent, a child, or a best friend. Just bring up that feeling of love that you felt. Feel it in your heart. Now you can say these words in your mind. May I be safe? May I be happy. May I be healthy. May my mind be at ease. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May my mind be at ease. And it's okay if it's hard not to feel this right now. This feeling will grow over time. It may not feel authentic, but know that your intention is there. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May my mind be at ease. Take a moment and just feel that. Now, I want you to think of someone that's a role model, someone that you look up to. Someone that you feel is very, very wise, very kind, and very loving. And I want you to open your heart right now and feel the love and kindness flowing from you directly to them, knowing that they are open for receiving your love and your kindness. Now I want you to send them the wish of may you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. And may your mind be at ease. Picture these feelings flowing out of your heart directly to them. Now I'd like for you to think of a neutral person. Again, this can be somebody you just meet on the street. It could be somebody at the coffee shop, the library, somebody in the line that you meet picking up your kids from school. You gently wave to them and they wave back, but you really don't know them. Picture their image in your mind right now. You don't know what's going on in their life, but you're going to wish them love and kindness. So open your heart and say, may you be safe. May you be healthy. May you be happy. May your mind be at ease. Feel it leaving your heart, going out to them. Next, I want you to picture someone that you hold hostility to. There may be some angry feelings that you still need to release that you're holding on. You may feel that they've done you wrong in some way. You may not even know why you hold these feelings to them. You just know that you get an uncomfortable feeling in your stomach or through your body when you're around them. And just know that they deserve happiness and they deserve to be loved. And they are just as worthy as you are, as I am for these things. They deserve to be safe and they deserve to be healthy. In their mind, they deserve to be at ease. So let's open our heart again and let's wish them, may you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy, and may your mind be at ease. And again, if this is hard for you, just set that intention of wishing them love and kindness. And now let's open this up to the whole world. Every living thing, plants, animals, the beautiful earth that we live on, and all the people right now from all over. People who are suffering, people who are just trying to get by, and people who feel good. Everybody. And include yourself in this. And open your heart up really big. And just say, may you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May your mind be at ease. And just feel that going out, just growing bigger and bigger. It's just spreading. And then I want you to feel it coming back to you. Be open to receiving this love and this kindness from people all over the world, from people we don't even know. Let's just share together and create a safe place for us all, a safe, healthy earth, a place to be happy, a place to share, a place to be in community with all. Now just take some time just to feel that. May bring a smile upon your face. You may feel the warmness in your heart as it just goes through your body. Just sit in that pure joy, that love, and that kindness. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. And when you're ready, you can open your eyes. How are you feeling, Jen?
I love this meditation. I just don't do it very much. I learned this as a yoga teacher. Rachel, I lost your visual, but I did have your audio going the whole time, and it was really beautiful. I don't know if there's something going on with your computer or the internet, but your audio is very clear.
Okay.
And watching you, the peace that came over you as you were doing this, it was so lovely for me to be able to just watch you, because I, whenever I'm doing it, it's either for me or in a yoga room and my eyes are closed. So it was really fun to watch the peace come over you.
Well, thank you. It was fun
sharing this.
Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome.
As a life coach and an eating disorder recovery coach, and also as an energy worker, I know that you are a healer and a helper. And how can people follow you or kind of get into your orbit so that they can learn from you?
Well, I have a Facebook page. My business page is Living Life the Happy Way with Rachel Stokes. And there I post, you know, upcoming events. Of course, right now, we're going to be changing gears. I'm going to be creating some groups where we can come together and create a community. I'm finding my clients are really needing their community, and this is a way to do it. And it's also creating, it's helping me step out of my comfort zone, which we all need to do. So Living Life the Happy Way on Facebook. I have a web page. It's kind of under construction right now, but
okay. You're
more than welcome to go and check it out. And it's Living Life the Happy Way too.
Okay.
And, you know, people will ask, what do you mean living life the happy way? And it's not about parties and, you know, confetti and fun.
That's interesting. That seems kind of like an obvious statement to me. And that's funny that people get confused by that.
They do. And they think that we're going to be just, you know, having these, you know, like I said, group parties and how to be happy. And, but it's a feeling, it's an energy, mm-hmm. you know, what does true happiness mean? Mm-hmm. True happiness can mean sitting in quiet, learning how to be in this new environment and find joy mm-hmm. in it. So it's more than just going out and having a good time. I recommend going out and having a good time.
And you do that. I've seen you.
But happiness is more than that.
Well, thank you for bringing the metta to us today. If you've never heard of it, I'm leaving up these little four sentences that are so peace creating for you. Even when you get to the person who's hard to say it for, it's kind of powerful by the end of the meditation, how much calmer you mm-hmm. feel toward them.
And think about doing that.
Thank you, Rachel. I appreciate it.
Oh, yes.
I know. It must be very impactful. Yeah.
Yes. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you again. My pleasure.
Yes.
I appreciate you for doing this. Bye, everybody.
Goodbye.